guys, welcome on my channel Crochet with Joanna. Today I'm going to show you another doily project. This time it's gonna be small size doily. My is measured about 8 inches in diameter. For my project I'm using crochet hook size 1.5 millimeters and the thread in size 10. If you would like to, you can use a little bit bigger hook size, for example 1.75, to make this project a little bit bigger. So we've got not a lot around, so basically this project we can make even in one day. And as you can see, we've got also some interesting stitches, so I'm hoping that you will like this project. So on my channel I've got new project for patrons and members of my channel. So here is the picture. So I'm hoping that you are going to love this project as well. So the project is called How to Crochet Octagon Doily. So basically nice round doily for your table again. If you would like to join as a member of my YouTube channel or on my Patreon site, links you can find in a comment section down below this video. So once again, I would like to thank you very much for all who's actually supporting me. And now let's get started. Our work, we are going to start by making magic ring. So end of the yarn we need to put into the back to form a little cross and the loop. Now we are going to insert our crochet hook into the loop, then grab the yarn, chain one, and we are going to start first round. So we need to make sure that we are working on both strands, and we are going to make 6 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now we need to pull our tail to close our loop and slip stitch into the first single crochet. Second round, we are going to start with chain 2 instead of first part of the double crochet. Then into the same single crochet we need to work 2 double crochets together. So first 2 chain stitches we've got as a first double crochet, then next 2. When we've got 3 loops we are going to finish our stitch. So this is our first group of 3 double crochets together. Now chain of 3. Into the next single crochet we are going to make another 3 double crochets together. So 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops on our hook. Now we need to finish the stitch, chain of 3. And the same pattern we need to repeat in each single crochet. So 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 3 and another group. 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops, we can finish the stitch, chain of 3. So this is my fourth group and 2 more. In next single crochet again, 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops, chain 3 and the last one. 1, 2 and 3. 4 loops, then last chain 3 space. At the end of our round we are going to make slip stitch at the top of our first group of 3 double crochets together. So in total we've got 6. Round number 3 we are going to start by making slip stitch in our first chain 3 space, then chain 1, and now we need to work 4 single crochets in our first chain 3 space. 2, 3 and 4. Now chain 1, then we are going to skip our group of 3 double crochets together, and in next chain 3 space another 4 single crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Chain 1, then we have to skip next group, 4 single crochets in next chain space. 1, 2, 3 and 4. then chain one, and we have to skip next group. So the same pattern we have to repeat to the end of our round. In each chain 3 space we need to work 4 single crochets, and then just above each group of 3 double crochets together, chain 1 space. 1, 2, 3 and 4, then chain 1 and 4 single crochets in next chain space. 1, 2, 3 and 4. After our last chain 1 space, we are going to make slip stitch in first single crochet. So 6 groups of 4 double crochet of 4 single crochets and 6 chain 1 spaces. Now we've got round number 4, but instead of our last chain 1 space, I decided that we are going to make half double crochet in our first single crochet. So we can start directly from our chain space, and we need to make chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then in the same chain space 5 more double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we've got first group of 6 double crochets. Now chain 1, and we have to go directly to the next chain 1 space. Again, 6 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then chain 1, and into the next chain 1 space another 6 double crochets. So each time we have to skip all single crochets, all group of 4 single crochets. In each chain 1 space we need to work 6 double crochets, then chain 1. So we should have 6 groups of 6 double crochets and 6 chain 1 spaces. After our last chain 1, we are going to make slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Round number 5, we are going to start by making chain 1, then single crochet in our first double crochet. And now 1 single crochet in next 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Then single crochet in chain 1 space. And again, 1 single crochet in next 6 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then single crochet into the chain 1 space. So we are going to have exactly the same number of stitches, but instead of chain 1, now we've got single crochet. So we need to continue this pattern all the way around, and after the last single crochet we have to work slip stitch in our first one. Round number 6. So we've done slip stitch in our first single crochet of a group of 6 single crochets. So I'm not counting the single crochet as we've done in chain 1 space. So this is actually the first one. So we are going to make chain 1, and now we need to work 2 single crochets in our first single crochet. Now 1 single crochet in next 4 single crochets. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then 2 single crochets in our last, so 6 single crochet. So 2 in first one and 2 in the last one. Now 1 single crochet in single crochet as we've done in chain 1 space, and then we are going to repeat 2 single crochets in first one, 1 single crochet in next 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, then 2 single crochets in last one, 1 and 2, and again 1 single crochet in single crochet as we've done in chain space, and we are going to repeat. So 2 single crochets in first one, 1 single crochet in 4, in next 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, then 2 single crochets in 6, so into the last, then 1 single crochet in next, and again. So basically we've got 2 single crochets in 1, then 1 in next 4, 2 single crochets in next 1, 1 single crochet in next, then 2, 4, 2, 1, 2, 4, 2, 1. So this is our whole pattern, and after last single crochet we have to work slip stitch in first one again. Round number 7, we are going to start by making slip stitch in next two single crochets. So we've done slip stitch in our first one already, then slip stitch into the next two. We are going to start from the third single crochet, so chain one and single crochet in the same stitch as our last slip stitch. Single crochet in next stitch, then into the third one, so one and two, and now we've got third one. Two single crochets, one single crochet in next two single crochets. So we've got group of six single crochets. At the beginning we had to skip first two single crochets as we've done in one stitch, and at the end we have to skip only the second single crochet as we've done in our last stitch. So we've got at the beginning and at the end of our motif two single crochets. So this is the first one as we work the last single crochet, and now we are going to skip the second and also the middle one as well. So now we need to insert our hook in that loop, and we are going to work two double crochets, one and two, chain of three, then another two double crochets in the same loop, one and two. So after second group we are going to repeat our pattern. So again, we need to skip our first two single crochets as we've done in our first one, then single crochet into the third, single crochet into the fourth, two single crochets into the fifth, then one single crochet into the sixth and seventh. So again we've got group of six single crochets, and now we are going to repeat. So into the big loop again we have to work two double crochets, chain of three, and another two double crochets. And from now we have to repeat again. So first two single crochets we have to skip, then we need to work group of six single crochets, then the last single crochet we have to skip and work two double crochets, chain three and two double crochets. At the end, after last double crochet, we are going to make slip stitch in our first single crochet. Round number 8. After slip stitch in our first single crochet, we are going to start by making chain one and single crochet in the same chain stitch as our slip stitch. Now one single crochet in next five single crochets, one, two, three, four, and five. So we've got a group of six single crochets again. Now into our first double crochet, we need to work two single crochets. Into the second, one single crochet, chain of three, then into the third double crochet of our V stitch we have to work one single crochet, and into the fourth one two. So in first one and into the fourth one we need to work two single crochets, and now we are going to repeat one single crochet in our six single crochets, two, three, four, five, and six. Two single crochets in first double crochet, one single crochet in second, chain of three, one single crochet into the third one, and two single crochets into the fourth. One single crochet in next six single crochets. So now this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around, and after our last round we have to work slip stitch in first single crochet. Round number 9, we are going to start by making chain one, then single crochet in exactly the same stitch as we've done slip stitch at the end of our previous round. Now we are going to make chain one, then we need to skip two single crochets and five double crochets into the third one. One, two, 3, 4, and 5. Chain 1. Then we are going to skip another 2 single crochets, single crochet into the third one. Again, chain of 1. Then we are going to skip 2 single crochets and chain space as well, because our third single crochet is after chain space. So we all the time we are working in third single crochet. So if we've got our chain 2 space in our way, we need to skip chain 2 space as well. And 5 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Chain 1, then we need to skip 2 single crochets, single crochet in third. Chain of 1, then again we have to skip 2 single crochets, in third one, 5 double crochets. So all the time we need to skip 2 single crochets. Once we are working 5 double crochets, and once 1 single crochet. So now we are going to repeat this pattern all the way around. So now chain 1, then again 2 single crochets, into the third single crochet, chain 1, then again we have to skip 2 single crochets and chain space into the third single crochet, 5 double crochets. So in each second group of 5 double crochets, we need to skip chain 2 space as well. All the way around we should have 12 groups of 5 double crochets and 12 single crochets. At the end, after our last chain 1 space, we are going to work slip stitch in first single crochet. Now we are going to start round number 10. After slip stitch in our first single crochet, now chain 1, then single crochet in the same stitch as we've done our slip stitch. Single crochet in chain 1 space, then 1 single crochet in our first 2 double crochets. In third double crochet, we have to work single crochet, chain 3, then slip stitch into the same single crochet, so our last one. So now we've got picot, 1 more single crochet in the same double crochet. So in each third double crochet now, we are going to work single crochet, picot, and another single crochet. Then 1 single crochet in next 2 single crochets. And now single crochet in chain 1, single crochet in next single crochet, then single crochet in next chain 1. And again, in first 2 double crochets, 1 single crochet in each. In third one, single crochet, chain 3, slip stitch into the single crochet, and 1 more single crochet. Then single crochet in last 2 double crochets. And next, in chain space, in single crochet, in next chain space. So, as I said before, in each third double crochet, we are going to make single crochet, picot, and another single crochet, and then 1 single crochet in each stitch, in each single crochet or chain stitch. And this pattern now, we need to repeat all the way around. At the end, we have to work slip stitch in first single crochet. Now we are going to start round number 11. After slip stitch in our first single crochet, now we are going to work slip stitch in next 3 single crochets. 1, 2, and 3. So our round we are going to start in second single crochet before our picot. So this is the first and this is the second. So chain 1, single crochet, then we need to work chain of 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And we are going to skip single crochet, picot, and another single crochet. Single crochet into the second single crochet after our picot. I know, it's lots of single crochets right now. Chain of 4. Then we need to skip next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Single crochet into the 6th. So again, this is the second from our picot, 1 and 2. Chain of 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then we have to skip first single crochet after picot and 1 single crochet into the second. chain of 4. And now again, we have to skip next 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into the 6th single crochet. And this pattern now we are going to repeat all the way around. So now chain of 9, then chain of 4. Now we are going to start round number 12. After slip stitch in our first single crochet, now we are going to make slip stitch in first chain 9 space. Chain of 2 instead of our first half double crochet. Then into the same chain space we need to work another 2 half double crochets, 1 and 2, then 13 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And now we need to work another 3 half double crochets. So we've got 3 half double crochets at the beginning and 3 half double crochets at the end, between 13 double crochets. After last double crochet, now we are going to make single crochet in chain 4 and then we are going to repeat 3 half double crochets, 1, 2 and 3, then 13 double crochets, so again, and 3 half double crochets. In next chain 4 space, another single crochet. So after our last single crochet, we need to work slip stitch in second chain stitch of our first half double crochet. Now we are going to start round number 13. After slip stitch in first half double crochet, we are going to work slip stitch in second one. So this is mean that the first one we are going to skip. Now chain 1 and single crochet in the same half double crochet. Now single crochet in next half double crochet and then single crochet in each double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. Now single crochet in next 2 half double crochets, 1 and 2. The last half double crochet we are going to skip and we have to work single crochet in single crochet which we have done in chain space. And we are going to repeat. So now we need to skip first half double crochet. Now we need to work one single crochet in each stitch apart from the last half double crochet. So all the time we are going to skip the first one and the last one. And after our last single crochet in second last half double crochet, we are going to work single crochet into the single crochet which is in chain space. Then we have to skip again first half double crochet and then one single crochet in next 17 stitches. So after our last single crochet, we are going to work slip stitch into the first one. Now we are going to start round number 14. After slip stitch in our first single crochet, now we have to work slip stitch in next 6 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So our round we need to start from the 7th single crochet by working chain 1 and single crochet in this single crochet. Now chain of 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Then we need to skip first 3 single crochets and 1 single crochet into the 4th one. So we should have 6 single crochets left. Chain of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then we need to skip the rest of single crochets plus the middle one and on the next group, first 6 single crochets again. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Single crochet into the 7th and again chain of 12. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now we have to skip first 3 single crochets into the 4th one. 1 single crochet. Then again, we are going to skip the rest, the middle one, and the first 6. Chain of 6, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Single crochet into the 7th, then chain of 12 again. So at the top of each group, we are going to work 12 chain stitches and between 6. So our pattern, we need to continue all the way around. Now we are going to start round number 15. So after slip stitch in our first single crochet, now we need to work slip stitch in first chain space. Chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the our chain space we are going to make another 22 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we need to continue until 22nd double crochet, so in total we should have 23. After our last double crochet, we are going to make single crochet in chain 6 space, and then we are going directly to the next chain space. So quite similar as we've done 2 runs before. So 23 single crochets in each chain 12 space and single crochet in each chain 6 space. After last single crochet, slip stitch in third chain stitch of our first double crochet. Now we are going to start round number 16, so this is our last one round. After slip stitch in our first double crochet, now we are going to make slip stitch into the second. So this is mean that the first double crochet we are going to skip. Chain 1, then we need to work single crochet in our first double crochet and then single crochet in next 9 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So in total on this side, we've got 10 single crochets. Into the next double crochet, we are going to make single crochet, chain of 3, and slip stitch into our single crochet. So we've got picot again. Then one more single crochet in the same single crochet, and in next 10, we are going to make one single crochet. So on both sides of our picot, we should have 10 single crochets. So in the center, we've got single crochet, picot, and then another single crochet. So quite similar as we've done before when we had 5 double crochets in our group. So as I said before, the last double crochet we are going to skip, single crochet into the center one, and then we are going to skip first double crochet, one single crochet in first 10, then into the next one, single crochet, picot, and single crochet as we've done here. So this pattern we are going to repeat all the way around. At the end, we need to work slip stitch in our first single crochet, and then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial, and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.